السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I greet you with peace upon all of you, Muslims and non-Muslims everywhere. I wish you peace and happiness and joy and tranquility wherever you are, whenever you are. Especially we are wishing you this peace at our holy month of Ramadan, where we consider it to be the month of mercy, forgiveness, and being protected from the hellfire. But today you have a special greeting with a different flavor. A flavor with the lockdown inside our houses for the last few months because of the corona pandemic. An enemy that we cannot see and we don't know where it's coming from. An enemy which is claiming the lives of thousands and thousands of people every day, and we cannot stop it. Been surrounded by death and fear. And today, I will salute two professions and all the professional people working inside it. The first one is the medical field, with every staff, from the cleaner, the auxiliary, the nurses, the staff nurses, the sisters, the doctors, professors, junior doctors, researchers, everyone. And all the researchers at the universities who are trying to help them. Some of those doctors and sisters and nurses and cleaners and others have lost their lives. They came out with open heart, open mind, full of spirit to try to find corona with lack of resources or no resources. That's why some of them become martyrs at that time, and some of them are still suffering, but they have to stand up like angels to protect every and any one of us. The second profession or the second team is the civil society organization and its workers, from the humanitarian to the developmental and others, who are building the infrastructure of our society, of our community, of our country, of our nation, who are stabilizing our state. Because a state without stronger civil society is in a weak and shambolic situation. I can see all of them nowadays, especially who are working in the humanitarian field or the social field, going out in Africa and different parts of the world, risking their life in the middle of corona to stretch their hands to help as much as they can. With a flood like what's happening in Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan a day ago, or everywhere, and reaching the most vulnerable and the affected community in these areas, whether it's in Syria or Yemen, in Palestine, Gaza, Eritrea, everywhere. Everywhere. Even in UK, we have some of our young volunteers being infected by corona. They couldn't be able to stop helping people where they are. My appeal to those countries who spend most of their budget on military and security. Military and security are not going to fight corona. Military and security are not going to fight AIDS. Military and security are not going to fight SARS and swine fever and others. I salute also all the other professions in any country, from the teaching profession, education, agriculture, industrial, economics, and others, the unsung heroes of all these societies, for without them, we cannot function. Why should we spend trillions of pounds every year on military and security, and deprive the other social services in our country from what they have to develop and protect our nation? Protection is not by a bullet, or by a gun, or by a missile, but a fighter plane, or a jet plane. No. 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 Protection is by education. By education. By education. By empowering the teachers, empowering the universities, empowering the research fellows and the research institution. Those are the people who will be able to protect and save our countries, protect and save our generations to come, and protect and save humanity. We only need security if there's a crime, or to prevent the crime. And we need the military to protect the borders. But we need the people who will be able to plant all the trees, the beautiful trees inside our society, to enable the humanity or the whole world to see how good, civilized, dedicated, educated, committed to the purpose of saving humanity by others. We respect the military as well as we respect the security, but we have to respect every profession. Corona now cannot be defeated by a gun, as I said before. No, it only be defeated by science and technology. It only be defeated by doctors, nurses, auxiliary, and sisters and others. Only be defeated by being together, living in one stronger society, by civil society organization. These are the profession that we need each and one of these government to invest money heavily in them. Social services, as much as we spend on social service, plus or not ignoring the military and security. May Allah bless you all, and may Allah let us to come out of this corona knowing how to stop it coming back, or how to fight any other pandemic, whether it's man-made or it's natural. This is not my cup of tea now. What my cup of tea now is education, education, education. Without education, we are ignorant zombies. We are ignorant zombies. We are ignorant zombies. Assalamu alaikum.